Hello and welcome to Wax on Wednesdays. This week I thought it would be fun to explore some line and mark making with just black and a little bit of gold India ink. So I just grabbed some simple tools from around the studio and going to have some fun playing, making, seeing what marks can be made with and dramatic effects with just some black India ink on a white encaustic surface. And these are just the 6x6 Masonite boards that I've added about 4 layers of white encaustic medium to infused flat. And in my larger paintings, when I'm working with India ink, I usually use it as my final layer. And the India ink likes to sit on top of the encaustic surface. It will dry, but it likes to sit on top. It doesn't fuse into the encaustic surface like the oil pigments or the soft pastels do, and they absorb into the wax. The India ink will always sit right on top, and if it's fused too much, it'll begin to crack. So you want to be careful and just fuse it a little bit, and mostly it'll just dry on its own right there on the encaustic surface. So here I'm taking a catalyst wedge, and this has a serrated edge to it. It's just kind of fun to make some marks with the India ink and explore what this catalyst wedge can do, the different using the different sides of it. And a lot of times on these boards you'll see, oh, I would have stopped at this point or I would have stopped at that point. And this is kind of just an exploration. I'm just continuing and pushing on and seeing what marks can be made on these little practice boards. And it's just kind of fun to see what can happen when you push or pull or add, use different edges, use different sides to your tools, use them in a way different than you're normally used to using them. Just kind of explore and see what they can do on these little practice boards. And every time I am fusing it, but I'm only fusing it to a glisten or a shine, the wax and the India ink, I'm not ever trying to set the India ink into the encaustic surface because I know that that's not possible. And that it'll begin to just crack if I overfuse it. And here I'm just taking a sponge. I just cut off a little piece of sponge, and this is my new favorite tool. I've used it for a couple years now, and it's just a little baster, I guess, a little turkey baster. I think it's Betty Crocker, and I got it from the dollar store, but I did leave a link. I found them on Amazon for a set of 4, I think, and so the link is there on the blog today with all the list of the supplies that I used. And I think it was a pretty good price considering it was a pack of 4. And you might look at your local dollar store though and see if they have them available too. I picked up a bunch, and it's just really fun to play with these inks and this little baster. It makes some really cool marks. When I'm looking for things to use with the India inks, I'm always looking for something that's going to make a bold line or bold mark, and then also that really delicate fine line detail too. So it's always really exciting to find out when a tool is going to do the extreme of one or the other. And this turkey basting tool, I thought it might be sort of clumsy and add some clumsy marks. And here it's added some really fine line and fine detail. So it's pretty exciting. And so I know that going forward in larger paintings that I can use this tool to add some very fine feathery line work and just sort of keep that in my tool arsenal. And here when I fuse it, it's kind of making a little lacy cell mark, almost like when you do a shellac burn. And sometimes that happens and sometimes it doesn't with the India ink. So I was just kind of going forward and seeing what could happen with that as I fused it without overfusing it. And here I'm taking a regular catalyst wedge, and this is one of my favorites. It's number 1. And I'm just making some, again, fine line. And this one is a great tool for the India ink because you can make both bold and very, very fine lines with the same tool. You never have to change tools. You can make all these great marks and lines just with this one wedge. And so I'm sort of exploring the positive and the negative here, and going with it and just seeing all that can be done with this. And by scraping almost all the India ink off, I can go ahead and make some more fine darker lines on this. And this is just a really fun tool to use with India ink. Okay, and on this one, I didn't like at all the marks, the way it was going. And of course, the India ink is permanent, so the more you try to wipe it off of your encaustic surface, the more it's going to sort of just spread and turn black. So this is a good little tip, is alcohol. This is just alcohol, rubbing alcohol, regular rubbing alcohol in this little spray bottle, and it will take the India ink right off with a paper towel. And here I've just got a sponge applicator and just painting it on very dark, bold lines. And I wanted to explore and see what had happened if you spray the alcohol ink right on it. If it's done on like a Yupo paper or something like that, it usually will spread and get some cells or some holes and some circles in it. And not so much here on the encaustic surface, come to find out, but it does give it a really nice mottled effect, almost like the back of carbon paper. If you've seen that, what the back of carbon paper looks like, kind of that white gray sort of surface, and that's what it ended up looking at like when it dried. So I thought that was kind of cool, and go ahead and add some darker, finer line to that. So I've got a mottled, bold, but mottled line on one half, and on the other part I've added some darker fine line, so that's a nice contrast. And then here I'm adding just some gold, some fine line to the gold on the mottled half of it. So that was a good fun little exploration there to see, just sort of play with the tones of black. And here I'm adding some gold, and I probably would have stopped on this composition a little sooner. But I'm just exploring again, exploring this catalyst wedge and exploring what can happen, what these lines look like together. And these are just good little practices to do on these little boards before you go ahead and apply these on a larger painting. It's just really exploring and seeing what you enjoy and the marks that you can make and the marks that you enjoy and how they look together. And here I'm just adding some drips. Just seeing how a drip looks with we have a very almost geometric lines going here with this catalyst wedge, and this the free form of the drips, and seeing how I like those together with the gold, and just continuing to explore with this. And now I'm just going to cover it all up with the catalyst wedge. I really like the dark, how I when you apply the flat edge of the blade, you can apply that light overall mark, but it's not as bold as the sponge. The sponge applicator would go solid black, where this you can actually draw some lines through it and create a little bit of drama within that dark area. And while it's wet, I'm just exploring what this wedge can do while the ink is still wet and how I can play with it. And see what marks I can make just playing with the ink on the encaustic surface. And now I took a little bit of that alcohol, rubbing alcohol, and applied it onto the edge of the blade. And just sort of peeling back a little bit and going back into that India ink and taking some out, making some areas lighter or darker. And that might be a nice exploration for applied to a larger painting as well, just sort of exploring the darkness of the outside lines and bringing some light into the inside. So I hope you enjoyed these techniques, and we will see you next Wednesday. Happy creating!